Hey guys, this video is the part two video of the properties of light, and we're going to look at the speed of light calculations. Now, we looked at the electromagnetic spectrum, okay? We went over radio waves, microwaves, infrared, visible light, ultraviolet, x-rays, and gamma rays, and how they differentiate. Okay, so as you go left to right across this table, the wavelength gets smaller. However, as you go left to right across this table, the frequency gets larger. So they're inversely related. Okay, now the speed of light calculations are done from time to time trying to solve for the variables. Now, the speed of light equals 3.00 times 10 to the 8th meters per second. This is how fast all light travels. All light travels at the same speed. However, there's times that you're going to have to solve for these two variables, wavelength and frequency. So, going forward, let's check it out. Let's do a little sample calculation here. All right, so if we start out, okay, with this formula here, we want to solve for wavelength. Okay, so what we do is, with the formula for speed of light, we basically divide both sides, okay, by frequency. That way, frequency will cancel out, leaving C over wavelength, okay? Now, for frequency, to get frequency, we use the starting formula up here, and we divide both sides by wavelength. Okay, whereas the wavelength will cancel out, and frequency equals speed of light over wavelength. And remember, C is always 3.00 times 10 to the 8th meters per second. So when you have to plug in a number for C, you use this number right here. Okay, now there's also the little density triangle, but I converted it over to the speed of light triangle. So if you were to use this, you need it in a pinch. This is the just like the density triangle, but you have the C at the top. So if you're trying to solve this, you just do it just like the density triangle. You cover up the variable you're looking for, and whatever's remaining is the formula. So if you're looking for C, you cover up C, and it's wavelength times frequency. If you're looking for frequency, cover up frequency, it's C over wavelength. If you're looking for wavelength, cover up wavelength, it's C over frequency. Very simple. All right, now let's look at a couple problems here. All right, let's look at this first problem here and see what they're asking us here. Now it says, what is the frequency of a light wave with a wavelength of 2.1 times 10 to the negative 7th meters, and what kind of light is it? Well, there's two parts to this problem. The first problem is, what is the frequency? So that's what we're looking for. Okay, so frequency equals what? That's the question. Now our wavelength is given right here. Okay, our wavelength is 2.1 times 10 to the negative 7th. This here, this number has two significant figures. So you have to remember sig fig rules, so our answer should have sig figs. And to answer this part of the question, we're going to need to look at the copy of the electromagnetic spectrum. So it's pretty simple here. So our formula for frequency is frequency equals speed of light over wavelength, right? Okay, so we know the speed of light is 3.00 times 10 to the 8th meters per second, right? Now our wavelength is 2.1 times 10 to the negative 7th meters, okay? Now the, let's see, the meters will cancel out, leaving us per seconds. So now we do the simple math. We do 3.00 times 10 to the 8th divided by 2.1. We get 1.4 times 10 to the 15th per seconds, or we can say hertz. Okay, because per seconds is the same as hertz. All right, now the other part of the question is, what kind of light is it? So let's look at this frequency here. Okay, 1.4 times 10 to the 15th. Let's go back to electromagnetic spectrum. Okay, to the 15th, that's in between 14 and 16. So we look up, so that's ultraviolet light. OK, Okay, so right here, it's the UV light. All right, so we're going to say ultraviolet light. Okay. Now, the next problem, let's check it out. It says, what is the wavelength of a light wave with a frequency of 1.7 times 10 to the 20th? Now, this here, wavelength equals what? We need to find out the wavelength. But our frequency is this right here. Okay? So our wavelength formula is C over frequency. All right, so we're going to be like 3.00 times 10 to the 8th meters per second divided by the frequency, which is 1.7 times 10 to the 20th per seconds. All right. Now, the seconds cancel out, which is a good thing. You divide these two numbers, 3.00 times 10 to the 8th divided by 1.7 times 10 to the 20th. Okay. And we get 1.8 times 10 to the negative 12 meters. Okay. So that's the wavelength. So now let's go check out to see what kind of light it is. So we go back to the electromagnetic spectrum. 10 to the negative 12, which is right here. 10 to the negative 12, which it's... falls in the gamma ray bracket. Okay, we could say these are gamma rays. Okay, all right, so now I want you guys to do two problems on your own. Okay, the first problem is, let me slide it over. What is the frequency of light having a wavelength of 1.0 times 10 to the 14th. Pause the video, copy this down. And second problem is, what is the wavelength of light having a frequency of 1.0 times 10 to the 4th seconds? Okay. Now, pause the video, copy that down. Now, after you solve both problems, go back to electromagnetic spectrum and identify what kind of light it is. So I'm going to pause the video now and you're going to work on those two problems. All right, so let's check your answers here. So for the first practice problem, you should get 3.0 times 10 to the 22nd per seconds or hertz, which equate to gamma rays. And for the second problem, you should get 3.0 times 10 to the 4th meters, which are radio waves. Alright guys, so these problems aren't too difficult, it's just determining the correct number of sig figs and which variables you have to use in order to solve the problem. And being familiar with electromagnetic spectrum and whether you're looking at wavelengths, remember it's decreasing from left to right on this chart for wavelength, and it's increasing left to right on this chart for frequency. So whatever chart you're looking at, you have to make some sense of before you go about making your decision. But I like this one the best. It's pretty easy to work with. All right, guys, have a nice day. I'll see you later.